In the day's other news, the Trump administration's new COVID-19 advisor says Americans should feel cautiously optimistic. Dr. Scott Atlas, who came on board this month, says infections and deaths are declining in hard-hit states, and there's no need to fear, even as more schools reopen. Confirmed cases nationwide topped 6 million today, with 183,000 U.S. deaths. A federal appeals court in Washington has refused to end the criminal case against Michael Flynn. The former national security advisor pled guilty to lying about contacts with Russia before President Trump took office. But the Justice Department had moved to dismiss the case. The appeals court also tossed a congressional lawsuit to make former White House counsel Don McGahn testify. House Democrats say they plan to appeal. In Lebanon, lawmakers endorsed diplomat Mustapha Adib as prime minister, designate today. The largest Sunni party, the Shiite Hezbollah and Christian blocs, all backed him in a rare display of unity. Today, Adib visited neighborhoods recovering from a devastating Beirut port explosion. He promised accountability.
Words fail to describe this horrific scene. We will try, as soon as the government is formed, to speed up the investigations and to have the investigations result given to the public as soon as possible.
Lebanon has also been rocked by protests over government failures as the country's economy crumbles. The first commercial flight from Israel to the United Arab Emirates landed there today, now that they have normalized relations. Emirati, Israeli, and American flags waved after the plane arrived in Abu Dhabi, with officials on hand, including Jared Kushner, President Trump's son-in-law and advisor. Back in this country, thousands of people in Louisiana are still waiting for power to return after Hurricane Laura. The extent of the damage crystallized this weekend as evacuated residents went home. Estimates for insured losses are now nearing $9 billion. The storm killed at least 18 people. In economic news, Delta, American, and United Airlines have now all abolished fees for changing domestic travel plans, hoping to get people flying again. And on Wall Street, the Dow Jones Industrial Average lost 223 points today to close at 28,430. The Nasdaq rose nearly 80 points to an all-time high, and the S&P 500 slipped 7, but had its best August since 1986, adding 7%. And Hall of Fame college basketball coach John Thompson has died. He made Georgetown University a national champion and was outspoken about matters of race. Jeffrey Brown looks at his life.
Georgetown will finish the year.
John Thompson Jr. made history that day in 1984, becoming the first black head coach to win an NCAA title. He was known for transforming Georgetown into a powerhouse and molding basketball greats like Patrick Ewing and Allen Iverson both on and off the court.
Coach Thompson was saving my life. No other schools were recruiting me anymore. My mom went to Georgetown and begged him to give me a chance. And he did.
Thompson saw his own role as going beyond basketball.
I could use it to open a doorway for myself or for other people. It was an educational instrument for me.
Thompson made a point of recruiting black athletes to the predominantly white campus and spoke out about injustices he saw. In 1989, he famously walked off the court before a game to protest an NCAA scholarship rule he felt would hurt disadvantaged students.
Because of the success we were having as a basketball coach, and me being an African American, I had an obligation to say something about it, so I did.
The NCAA ultimately modified the rule. John Thompson coached at Georgetown for 27 seasons and won almost 600 games. He was 78 years old. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Jeffrey Brown.
This is the PBS NewsHour from WETA Studios in Washington and in the West from the Walter Cronkite School of Journalism at Arizona State University.